He had a better game than Jaden Stevenson, who just had, I don't know, brain fade after brain fade. That was one of the more bizarre games of football I've ever seen from an AFL player. Today on the show, we talk AFL and NRL. The Premier League is back, the Commonwealth Games, and we see one of the best blocks of the season from Giorgio Chiellini. Should get him playing volleyball, not bloody football. This is Zero Bucks Given. Getting things rolling today, of course, with the AFL, where Geelong continue to keep their season going, their 11-game win streak rolling. And somehow, they're not the only team that's currently on an 11-game win streak. When's one of these teams finally going to lose? This Collingwood game was definitely made quite spicy against Melbourne after Ed Langdon's comments saying that they were all duck, no dinner. And it's fair to say that Maynard made Langdon his dinner after that comment. One thing I'm pissed off about that I can't show you is the Collingwood Football Club Twitter account. They tweeted quack after their game. Perfect, brilliant. But for some reason, they deleted it. Whoever told the Collingwood admin to get rid of that tweet, you are spineless. Come on, man. And on the topic of spineless, by the way, the Carlton Football Club. The drop-off of this team is quite staggering. I'm convinced they won't make finals. We'll have a look at the ladder a little later. Josh Kennedy kicked 8 goals in his last game at home, which is pretty ridiculous. He had a better game than Jaden Stevenson, who just had, I don't know, brain fade after brain fade. That was one of the more bizarre games of football I've ever seen from an AFL player. Buddy was able to stroll in and kick an easy goal. Michael Wilson took this really nice photo of him and asked the question, is this Buddy's first goal on his right foot? Genuine serious question. Only to get hit with, yes, this was his first right-footed goal since last week, pretty much. Goodness, but 2 rounds left to go. Looking at the ladder, there's 2 spots in finals left available. And I'm telling you now, I think Richmond will make it. I don't think Carlton are going to finish in the 8. I reckon it'll be the Bulldogs that just get there in on, I don't know, percentage. On to the NRL, though, where we had Ricky Stewart in the news for, shocker, not really mincing his words in a press conference. I think the term weak gutted dog is going to be hanging around for quite a while. Look, someone even really kindly posted leaked footage of the confrontation that led to his dislike of Jaben Salmon. But a $20,000 fine for Ricky, so we hope his little bust-up was worth it. Some big results as well in terms of the race for the finals, with the Roosters getting a big win against the Broncos. A huge win for the Rabbitohs, 48-10. This was also the game where we got the weekly pitch invader who got hit pretty hard front on. Yeah, this streaker definitely got a little bit more than what he bargained for. And somehow that wasn't the only bloodshed on NRL turf. My God, Victor Radley was absolutely gushing. It was a big one. But anyway, with the Roosters win, they're still just behind the Broncos, but staying in touch. Finals right around the corner as well. Me at 6 p.m. Just going out for 1 or 2 beers. Me at midnight. Look at all that. Finally, at long, long last, the Premier League is back, and now we have fresh new faces to watch, such as Erling Haaland. Assist De Bruyne, goal Haaland. Watch how many times this pops up this season. That combo is going to be scary. They got a big 2-0 win against West Ham away, and one of the classic Haaland interviews already. He's already off the mark. It's fantastic to see. On the other side of Manchester, they lost 2-1 at home. Ronaldo didn't even start. He had to come off in the second half. And now Erik ten Hag knows the level of the job he has ahead of him. He has walked into an absolute firestorm. Manchester United centre-back partnership. This is too difficult to explain, but if you know, you know. Liverpool only managed a 2-2 draw against Fulham away as well, and after the game, we had Jurgen Klopp complaining about the pitch, and then Fulham ended up tweeting this, which is just a whack and a half. Simply amazing response. Jurgen Klopp reading this, looking like hell of X right now. And we also saw Newcastle's Alan Saint-Maximin just casually giving a random fan a Rolex to celebrate the return of the Premier League as well. You know, just as you do. Good on Alan Saint-Maximin. He was a part of a Newcastle team that won 2-0 and had to deal with this corner routine. It didn't quite work out. And away from the Premier League, we saw Messi score his first ever bicycle kick goal in his entire, 15, 16, 17 year career. He's already a third of the way to equaling his league goal total from last season. You know, the GOAT's underway. And now finally on to the Commonwealth Games, where Australia's campaign has concluded and we are number one, the champions, dripping in gold, like I said last week. Our ladies cricket team got it done. The Diamonds got it done, actually winning our 1,000th Commonwealth Game gold medal. First nation to hit that total, and I think England's in second with like 700-something, but they're probably going to have to wait another 20 years to get it. That's mad. Our women's hockey team won silver after they got to the gold medal game from a... I can't believe I'm saying this. They just restarted the shootout. India got screwed. Something about the clock not starting, I don't know, but they won the shootout, clean sweep them, and the Kookaburras also beat India 7-0 in the final. It was annihilation. Australia always the father, I swear, but look at Ollie Hoare. This was the real big story of the games. He beat two world champions, came from a mile back to win the 1500 meter final. Absolutely insanity. Just ridiculous effort. We also got an all-time Bruce McAvaney call as well, which I'm always for, but Ollie Hoare, amazing job by you, son. But one final look at the medal tally, and it's Australia on top. We just got two more medals in England, but 10 more gold. Big shocker, the Aussies are clear. Anyway, let's move on to legend of the week now, ladies and gentlemen. I feel like I know who I want to give it to, but let's see what your nominations are. Of course, as I do all the time on Twitter, ask you for your nominees. Jota for getting three assists. There's always one guy that keeps giving, I don't know, whatever. Moving on, we've got Andrea Spend... Oh my God, this is really bad that I wasn't quite sure. Spendolini, Siri... Oh my God, this is too much. We had a 17-year-old win two diving gold medals. All right, that's sick. I'm sorry I can't pronounce your name. Marlon Pickett shushing the crowd. I did see this. Some young fan was giving it to Marlon Pickett in the pocket. He slots a beautiful goal, gives him a shush, but the fan was actually smiling back, which you got to love. Respect all round. We've got Nick Faldo getting a nomination. Yeah, it was after 16 years, his final broadcast for CBS. And I got to say, this guy has been iconic in the booth, so he will be sorely missed. And he had an amazing send-off. And Nick Kyrgios also gets a nomination. Yeah, he won his ATP title. Fair enough, he did win another ATP singles title. And what's even more insane, I'm only just learning this now, he also won the doubles on the same day. That is ridiculous. That's pretty nuts. And I know that no one nominated him, but I'm gonna give it to him anyway, because I'm gonna veto everyone on this. On this one occasion, I think it's fair. Ollie Hoare for one of the more iconic moments in Australian sport. If I didn't give him Legend of the Week, it would eat away at my consciousness. So he's got it, it's his. Just like his gold medal. Congratulations, mate. Congratulations to all the athletes of the Commonwealth Games. Done Australia proud, number one again. And ladies and gentlemen, we will see you all next week. Thank you all so much for watching this one. Catch you all again soon. See you later, and bye-bye.